Okay, this morning I got harassed by a security guard who I could have totally killed with a pinky for kicking in the display of an automated car wash kiosk at the gas station because it only gave me 30 seconds of air to dry my entire minivan, and when I attempted to get a refund, the machine repeatedly demanded another $3.75 for 2 more minutes of air. 1. 30 seconds isn't enough time to dry a smart car, let alone an entire Windstar, you stingy son of a bitch computerized piece of shit. And 2. I'm not paying almost $4 for a filthy cockeyed insulation tube to blow the wrong direction on my car for another 2 minutes, you shitbag fuck. Anyway, here are some news stories to make this completely infuriating incident seem like a blowjob from the Sports Illustrated bikini team. First up, China is claiming that one of their satellites have located the crash site of that Malaysian airliner that went down over the ocean last weekend. Considering it was probably one of their shitty MiGs or faulty surface-to-air missiles that mistakenly shot the plane down in the first place, I award China no points and may God have mercy on their commie-loving, iPhone-making souls. Seriously, after all these years, how good of a movie is Billy Madison, right? Second, these two fucking nerds, also known as President Barack Obama and whatever the fuck the Prime Minister of the Ukraine is called, have issued a stern warning to Russia regarding upcoming elections in the disputed and cluster-fucked region known as Crimea. It has not been reported, but it is still highly suspected that criminal mastermind slash former head of the KGB slash current Russian president Vladimir Putin didn't even get the warning because he was busy riding around bareback on some horse somewhere, shirtless, hunting Kamchatka brown bear cubs with a piece of a cinder block tied to a jump rope. So good luck with that, guys. Warn the fuck away, you nerds. Third, the widow, or more accurately, wife of former Penn State assistant football coach Jerry Sandusky, how has this guy not been killed in jail yet, has told reporters that she thinks her husband is innocent and that he was convicted of child molestation by the news media before his case even went to trial. Yes, the same court case where he was convicted of 45 counts of child molestation and from which Penn State has agreed to pay over $60 million in civil settlements to his victims. Dude, our legal system can be fucked sometimes, but not nearly as fucked as those kids you took advantage of in those showers. So buck up and take your prison rapes like a man and stop having your wife do your belly aching for you. Fucking scumbag pedophile fuck. In lighter criminal news, not involving child rape, police in Portland, Oregon apprehended a 22-pound house cat over the weekend after its owners called 911 because they were barricaded in a bedroom with their infant son in an attempt to flee from the fat and possibly flatulent feline's wrath. What in the fuck is wrong with people? It's called a hammer. They're not expensive. Handle your shit, pet owners. And other shitty things that live with people news, the private school high school cheerleader who sued her parents for kicking her out of the house and refusing to pay her bills and or tuition is returning home this week to her parents who she tried to sue's house. Holy fucking monkey shit. Again, it's called a hammer. They're not expensive. Handle your spoiled brat kid shit, parents. P.S. I'm totally kidding and obligated to say that I in no way condone beating your child with a hammer if they sue you, no matter how cunty they may or may not be. That's the news for today. Please leave a comment and like this stupid video down below and share it with your friends. Or don't. I'm not the goddamn boss of you. Until next time, this is AFT Ranger for the AFT News Network. If it fucks with you, kill it with a hammer.